Hey, what's up everybody? It's Stacy Storino. Welcome back to my channel, the number one place for entrepreneurs who want their content marketing to convert content consumers into paying customers. Do you feel like you're engaging in all of this organic content marketing on platforms like Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, and more, only to find that you're not getting any conversions that are important to your business? Well, let's change that right now. In this video, I'm going to discuss how to engage in content marketing for business conversions. But before I forget, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to get real world help that entrepreneurs like you need to succeed with content marketing that drives traffic to your business so that you can do more business. Now, let's discuss conversion categories and then drill down a little deeper in terms of conversion types so that from now on, ideally when you engage in content marketing, especially on social media platforms, that you're not wasting your time spinning your gears with busy work. Because I'm telling you, organic content marketing can work if you know what you're doing as you publish that content to platforms such as, let's say, Facebook and Instagram. Two conversion categories. Okay, so there are two main conversion categories, the way I teach my students to look at things when it comes to organic content marketing via social media, and they are macro conversions and micro conversions. You do need both to move people along what I refer to as a sales spectrum, where they start as digital content browser and you turn them into an actual buyer. Or put another way, let's check out my Funnel Fairy Godmother marketing and sales funnel image here, and you can see that while at the top of the funnel, when it comes to organic content marketing, if you optimize your social media content that you publish properly so that it can be found in search by your ideal customer using, let's say, the search feature on Facebook or Instagram, where they're searching for content to binge on keywords and hashtags, then in time, lots of people may become content browsers where they find your content, they become aware of your brand and its offerings, and maybe they'll become interested enough to follow you on social. After a while, for some people, it'll be minutes to hours. To others, it could be days or weeks. It depends on the person. They'll become interested enough to opt into your email list, say, with your link in bio on Instagram or through a link you drop on Facebook. Between your email marketing to them, now that they're on your list, and through continued social media content marketing on the daily, you should stay top of mind with them, and they'll eventually take action and buy from you if they are an ideal customer of yours to begin with. Provide value, engage in awesome relationship content marketing, and not just straight up sales messaging all the time, and you're going to create a parasocial relationship with each email list opt-in VIP, and sooner or later, the right people are going to buy your products and or your services. Now, let's take the first of the two conversion categories when it comes to organic content marketing and social, and that is micro conversions. Too often entrepreneurs make the mistake of having their social feeds just serve as a parade of product photos and a tsunami of sales announcements, as I often say. Then they're surprised that no one seems to follow or really opt into their email lists or buy from them, or nobody much does. Can you get sales just by publishing photo after photo of products and sales messaging otherwise? Sure. Can you get a lot more by providing value ad type content that is not directly salesy, but could be starring your products nonetheless, that resonates with your ideal customer? They're vibing with it. That causes them to give you more micro conversions. Sure. And just to be clear, micro conversions are little micro steps that don't cost a browser any money. Like, becoming a buyer would, of course. So those are actions on their part that could include liking posts, engaging with them, commenting on them, sharing them, saving them, at mentioning you, let's say on Instagram, messaging you behind the scenes via Facebook Messenger or in the DMs or direct messages on Instagram. The more they engage with your content and even you as the business owner, the more likely it is that they will find themselves moving, sometimes even despite themselves, from content lurkers to followers, email list opt-ins, and actual buyers. And that leads us to the topic of macro conversions. These are truly what you need for your business to succeed. And these types of conversions do include getting social followers or subscribers, email list opt-ins, and of course, the most important macro conversion of all, sales. But it's often hard to get people to drop all the way down to the bottom of that sales funnel from the first time they discover a piece of content of yours organically in search on platforms such as, let's say, Facebook and Instagram. While the macro conversions are the most important, the micro conversions are often the things that get you there. Now, while plenty of people don't need your urging to like a post, they'll do it on their own, some folks. Others are squirrel brain central and overloaded and kind of mindlessly consuming content in a very passive way. If you don't take them by the hand, so to speak, in the caption of your post, or if your content is a video or audio file within the content itself, and say, hey, please like this post or comment and let me know what you think of X down below, that sort of thing. Well, fewer people will do that on their own than you'll get if you actually ask. And so the more often you can get micro conversions, the more likely it is with most ideal customers of yours, if they really do want what you have to sell to them, the more likely it is they'll end up giving you the micro conversions you need to succeed and the macro conversions too. And yes, sure, sometimes you're gonna have a sales announcement type social media post that will just directly ask for the sale. And as long as you're not violating a platform's terms of service, in terms of how you go about things, you're fine to do so once in a while. Not all the time. Not every single post. That's a little too salesy for a lot of people on social, especially if you're not a well-established brand within your industry. You're trying to create a grassroots revolution of brand enthusiasts, many of whom will buy from you when they know, like, and trust you enough. So yes, some posts should seek one micro conversion, such as like this post if you want to see more content like this, or comment down below to let me know what you think of X, or share this post with someone who you know could use this information or inspiration, whatever your value add type post is about. But no, the confused mind doesn't buy and the confused mind doesn't convert. So don't go for more than one micro conversion or macro conversion per post. It usually won't work. Can there be an exception to the rule? Perhaps, but my advice in general is, since I feel that you should be publishing daily content to the top two social media platforms that are most important to your niche, minimum. Well, you can have one particular theme for your daily content call to action. Is it a micro conversion kind of day because you're running a sale? A macro conversion kind of day? Is it a micro conversion kind of day because you're not currently running a sales promotion? So you should be relationship marketing instead. So you want your digital community of brand enthusiasts to talk to you in the comments or DMs. Save a really great value add video or PDF you just created and shared, and so on. One conversion category and one call to action per post, please. You're more likely to have more successful content marketing for business conversions when you do that. Both conversion categories are VIP. So remember, you can't just create content, no matter how beautiful or cool or impressive it is in terms of the media, and just fling it onto social media platforms like Facebook and Instagram, and then get frustrated when you're not getting any of the micro conversions or macro conversions you need for your business to succeed. You likely have to be a lot more strategic than you're used to being online, especially if you're an older content creator and or entrepreneur. But in time, you'll see that while sales are super important, the most important conversion for your business to get for sure, you'll likely need to wine and dine your brand's community of followers, subscribers, and other content consumers before you can seal that most important deal. That means focusing on micro conversions and not just macro conversions. Some days the focus should be on relationship marketing. Other days the focus will, of course, be on straight up sales-based marketing. But with organic content marketing, it's entirely possible It took my family's business, Joe's Dairy Bar and Grill, from barely profitable going into 2016 to a seven-figure success 2.5 years later and beyond. It's turned many of my thousands of students into multiple five-figure and six-figure successes in a matter of months to a year. It's definitely helped my more beginner students go from failing to profitable too, for sure. Let's see what content marketing done right can do for you too. There you have it. This is my advice when it comes to the topic of especially organic content marketing for business conversions. Need more help? Be sure to check out these two awesome videos too, because they'll teach you great content marketing strategies that can also help to blow up your business. Enjoy.